It's time to dive deep into your soul and think critically about the world around you. What is this called? Science.
Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Hey kids, I'm Bill. Today we are going to talk about how DNA codes for proteins. How cool is that?
I love science.
First step in turning DNA into a protein is called transcription. Transcription is when the DNA, there's a template strand, and the DNA has to be coded into mRNA so that it can then be processed in mRNA processing. And we're going to have Eleanor talking a little bit more about mRNA processing. Isn't that right, Eleanor? That's right.
That's right, Bill.
So after mRNA processing, it goes to translation. And I know that our buddy Matt is going to talk a little bit more about translation. Isn't that right, Matt?
Sure thing, Bill.
Anyway, so translation is where the magic occurs, and the mRNA that was just processed is going to be turned into a protein. What? Craziness. I know.
Ooh.
This is a codon table. See all these letters? Each sequence of three letters is called a codon, and what it does is it tells what amino acid has to go in that spot. Pretty cool, right? As you can see, there are a bunch of sequences of three letters on this table, and each one of these codes for the amino acid that's next to it. Pretty simple, right?
All right, let's talk a little bit more about the codon table. All living things have similar genetic code. So in our DNA, we have the same nucleotides, and they can be arranged in similar orders, and this makes all living things very similar when you look at their DNA. The codon table applies to all of these living organisms, and thus this same DNA allows us to code for proteins that could be similar or the same in many organisms. Therefore, we can create GMOs, or genetically modified organisms. You do this by taking the genetic code from one organism and putting it in the genetic code of another organism. Why would you want to do that? Well, the codon table allows us to modify organisms to suit our needs. You can make crops bigger, you can make them more colorful, like a nice orange carrot, or even sweeter, like a sweet tomato. Why is this beneficial? Well, there's something called BT corn. You would know this better as sweet corn. Today, in American society, these GMOs that have allowed us to transfer these genes have made our taste buds like the sweet. But we don't want the sweet here. An insect-killing gene is transferred from a bacteria called Bacillus thuringiensis, or however you pronounce that big word. Anyway, this insect-killing gene allows the sweet corn to emit a poisonous chemical that kills off the bugs that are usually attracted to it. And this is really good, but why? Well, farmers otherwise would have to use insecticides, but with this insect-killing gene, insecticides no more, and farmers can avoid those harmful chemicals. So in conclusion, all organisms have similar genetic code, and when we transfer desirable genes from one organism to another, we can create new organisms that we like better than the old ones. I'm Bill Nye, the Science Guy, and that's my spiel on GMOs.
Oh yeah, cell zone, yo, macaron, yeah, macaron, no, chacaron.
Hi everybody, I'm here to tell you about transcription of DNA. So what happens is that DNA has to go from DNA in the nucleus to mRNA to go out of the nucleus. How they do that is if the DNA unzips it from structure in a section. And so you can see that it gets wider, and now they're going to use one strand of the DNA as the template strand for the mRNA to be copied off of. So if this is our template strand, you can see the first thing that happens is that there's a promoter, and this is called usually called a TATA box because it's thymine, adenine, thymine, adenine. This is upstream of the gene, meaning it becomes before the gene that we want to copy into mRNA. And so if you draw a box around it, you can see it. This is TATA box. So now these proteins called transcription factors come in and attach to the TATA box like this. These transcription factors call the enzyme RNA polymerase to come in and bind to the TATA box where the beginning of the gene is. The RNA polymerase will go in the 5' to 3' direction, synthesizing mRNA. It'll keep going in this direction until it reaches the AAUAAA. This is the polyadenylation sequence that tells the RNA polymerase to fall off. And now what happens is everything that's been copied is mRNA, and it's ready to be processed. So now back to you, Bill.
How DNA information is copied from DNA, I'm here to tell you about mRNA processing. Before the mRNA can leave the nucleus, it needs to be processed. The first step is capping. Capping occurs by adding a modified guanine to one end of the mRNA and a poly H out the other end. This occurs so that the mRNA can easily slip out of the nucleus and it prevents the mRNA from degrading. Next, splicing occurs. Splicing occurs when spliceosomes, like molecular scissors, cut up pieces of mRNA. The exons pieces stay, and the intron pieces leave. With alternative splicing, your cells are able to stitch together genetic information into different formations, which allows a single gene to code for thousands of proteins. This splicing thus adds the complexity of many organisms. So that's what capping and splicing are in mRNA processing. Now back to you, Bill.
Hi, my name is Matt, and translation is my favorite part of this process that we are learning about. Genetic code is the same in every eukaryote, not prokaryotes though. A codon is a specific 3-base sequence of mRNA that codes for one amino acid. And the interesting thing is, there's a thing called a wobble, and that is when more than one codon can code for the same amino acid. You may ask, why does this happen? This protects against the effects of mutation, because one base change may not affect the whole protein. Okay, ribosomes are, contrary to popular belief, they are a mix between proteins and rRNA. Very interesting. mRNA exits through the nucleus, exits through pores in the nucleus, and travels to a ribosome. Triplets of mRNA nucleotides are read one at a time. Codons must be read correctly in correct reading frames. tRNA enters the ribosome. The anticodon on the tRNA, as my assistant Eleanor beautifully drew, that binds to the corresponding codon and adds the correct amino acid to the growing peptide and creates a nice, good-looking peptide bond. All right, and to conclude, you may be wondering what these APE things are, and I can assure you, it's not an ape. No, but actually it is in fact the A site, the P site, and the E site. The A site is where the tRNA enters, mRNA, as you can see, and mRNA, believe it or not. And then the tRNA moves to the P site, and in the P site, it adds the amino acid to the peptide chain, and the P site is where the peptide is made. And finally, it goes to the E site, and E, as many of us know, is the first letter of the word exit. So that's how I like to remember it. It exits, bing, bang, boom. We're done, we're happy. We made some protein. We're feeling really good about ourselves. We're feeling healthy. And let's not forget that this happens for many, many tRNAs, and that the polypeptide bond is actually not yet a protein because it has to go through folding, which occurs, and then it becomes a nice, beautiful looking protein. and we're done.
Spliceosomes are molecular... Sorry. Okay. Splicing thus adds to the complex...
Got the club going up on the Tuesday. Got your girl in the cutter, she choosy. Club going up on the Tuesday. Got your girl in the cutter, she choosy. Club going up on the Tuesday. Got your girl in the cutter, she choosy. Club going up on the Tuesday. Got your girl in the cutter, she choosy.
Squad going up.
Nobody flipping now. I just did three in a row. Them shows is back to back to back now.
Yeah, no. Put the big shots on the at now, be like,
you know, me. Party in a weekend. Ain't got no
love.
Time. Wow.
Party on
super
the weekend.
Cool.
Tell Jello bring the juice.
More.
We about to get.
Oh, yes, yeah, very interesting.
It's party time.
Fill the room up with some things. One night off and this is it.
Alright guys, before I wrap it up, I just want to have a quick shout out to my sponsor, Geico. And then slowly transition to the E phase.
I think we getting too deep. I'm talking might be too true. Upstairs,
so,
I got.
Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe, like on my YouTube channel.
So I got them for today, you. We are going to talk about DNA replication.
I'm just going to have another
drink.
And when I'm putting work in on the weekend, I look back on this and think how we had the club going up on a Tuesday.
GMO.
Got your girl in the cut, she chooses. Club
what?
Going up.
Ma,
on a Tuesday.
What is that? How do I
got your girl in the cut, she chooses. Club going up.